just a little bit caught in the middle. Life is a maze and love is a riddle. I don't know where to go, can't do it alone. I've tried and I don't know why. Slow it down, make it stop, or else my heart is going to pop. 'Cause it's too much, yeah, it's a lot. Cause we're the two best friends that anyone could have. Hey! Anyone could have. Anyone could have. We're the two best friends that anyone could have. Hey! And no one can come between us.
Living with Tom is something that I have never experienced before. I can still live my life and have the goals that I want to achieve, and you know, I still work within the industry and making films and all that stuff, but then I get to come home to someone who can instantly change my mood from being, you know, a little bit stressed from running around and whatnot into completely just like, look how lucky I am to be able to come home to somebody that when he sees me, I can get the longest hugs in the world and I get told that I'm how much I'm loved 4 times a day, and that doesn't really ever happen on a casual day-to-day basis. So that's something that's so, so beautiful and rewarding. This is the document that I received when I first was introduced to the idea of living with Tom.
My name is Tom and you're doing very lucky.
I got it through an agency that is known as Sunshine Agency, and I had to go through an interview process with a police check and sit down and, you know, go through Tom's plan. This is an old one, 2013, but just list the goals that Tom wants to achieve in his life. My wonderful friend Yvie Jones, she spent a lot of time trying to convince me into moving in with her and Tom, and I was worried that I wouldn't be the right person for the job because I realized there were so many responsibilities with it. But then once I had, you know, come and visit Tom a few times and just saw how him and Yvie were together and how beautiful they acted, I knew that this is something that I could definitely do.
And saying that, I think it's even better for Tom because look at me. He must have hit the jackpot with me. And you're a consolation.
Get rid of her!
When I met you, I knew that you would be perfect for living in this situation. You were very much like me, just a bit uglier, and I liked that. Introduced you to Tom, and you came over, and you guys got along so well. You absolutely adored him, and that's what we needed in this house. You know, and I actually had you come over a few times and look after Tom and the dogs without me, by yourself. That was your test. And you passed.
There's a Leo. There's a Leo. There's a little dog.
Living with Tom, it's definitely not your standard situation, but I think it's really enjoyable. You are living just as flatmates, but it's more of a family feel, and there's a lot more love there, as if you're living with siblings or parents without the bossiness. Well, then there's my bossiness. But yeah, you care for each other like you do family. Like, it's an easy situation, but it can be stressful. There's different stresses from normal living. Like, you know, most people worry about what they're doing when they work or how much money they've got. But living with Tom, You're worried more about his diabetes and, you know, his health and whether he's upset. Tom lives in the moment, as you know, and that's a really wonderful thing to live with, because you kind of, you can bounce off Tom. What do you want to do now? He's very spontaneous. And like, if Tom's sick, you take care of him like he's a family member.
Pardon? Pardon? You're sad about your dad. Why are you sad about your dad? How did you think about that right now? That came out of nowhere.
You're okay.
Living with Tom is one of the most rewarding experiences that I've ever come across. His family have come up with this amazing plan to integrate Tom into the community. And I just think that people should ask themselves, why shouldn't Tom be able to live like all of us do and have the life that he wants to have? And I feel very, very blessed and privileged that I can be contributing to Tom's plan. I'm just a little bit caught in the middle of the maze. I don't know where to go. Come to me, I've tried, and I don't know why.
Maternal instincts crying out for a baby. No.
Always I like to do this.
Thank you very much.
That's the way, this is what happens. Thank you guys. Welcome to the first that happens.
To my living.
You're right. Okay?
Okay.
Got it.
Yay!
Thank you guys.